Hey, it's the man in the hat, and I'm back for another video. Thanks for your questions about the garden. I'm sorry for dropping the ball on that. You're right. I told you about all the planting that we were doing, and I haven't given you an update. Okay, a real quick message just to update you on the vegetable garden. A few of you have asked. Now, I earlier was mostly talking about the grapes and the raspberries and things like that we were planting, but I did also mention we're putting some things into the garden, and I'm going to try to give you a really down and dirty update on how things are coming. Mid-May, we'd put in the onions and a handful of seeds. I'll show you that in a minute. And then on the 4th, which is last Saturday, we put in the tomatoes, the peppers, the eggplant, and the Brussels sprouts. So I'm going to update you on those mostly and show you how they've been coming. We've had a really crazy range of weather. We've gone from super, super, super dry to really, really hot and humid to today thunderstorms. So you'll probably in just a second hear some thunder in the background. We've had incredible thunderstorms last night from about 1 until 3 in the morning. The whole house was shaking with huge thunder and lightning storm. A lot of water came down, but it seems to have been absorbed well by the garden because things had gotten so dry. So I will do a different update soon telling you all about the grapes, the raspberries, blackberries, blueberries, and the new fruit trees. Today I'm just going to focus on what's happening in the garden. And I forgot one thing. It's the melons. Those are also in. What did we plant yesterday? Let's start with the tomatoes. Beaverlodge 6808, Cherry Buzz, Cuore Di Bue, Green Zebra, Kellogg's Breakfast, Sweet Seedless, 4th of July, Tye-Dye, Brandy Boy, Orange, Wellington, Swin Steak Sandwich. And for eggplant, we planted Casper, Prosperosa, Millionaire, Fairy Tale Organic, and the peppers. What did we plant for peppers? We planted Felicity, Pizza, Créme Brulée, Ancho Magnifico Pepper, Ascent, Pepper, California, 1 of 300. It looks like the remainings are the Franklin Brussels sprouts and the Dimitri Brussels sprouts. Here's what we planted earlier on in May. We've got onions, beautiful onions. These have been in the ground now for coming up on a month. Several different varieties. You also have mixed in as we get closer to the end of those, some leeks. Next is the Swiss chard. That's coming in pretty nicely. Need to do a little bit of thinning and some weeds in there that need to go away as well. Nice close up here. Some peas. Split in amongst the peas. There are actually some kale, some Netta the Toscana, but it's hard to see. And these down here are the radishes. Go in for a real close look at the radishes. So now we're going to flip forward a day. This is June 6th. I've had a couple of questions about what it is that we do to keep pests out of the garden. The truth is we don't do a very good job with the squirrels in particular, and the birds and the chipmunks are always tough early in the season. But the two main things that we do, and I'm just showing you here the plants the morning after we plant, I'm showing they've recovered pretty well. The two main things that we do to keep bigger animals out, we do have a fence that goes around the whole garden area. Here's you see a gate going into it, and then we have a wonderful dog.
In the back, Griffin. All right. He's out helping me inspect the garden, taking a quick look at things as the sun's setting into the west. So you can see the last couple of days have been a little hard on these new tomatoes. At least a couple of them. It's the local town whistle for the volunteer fire department to go to their meeting. And you see it down there on the bottom there, some new growth popping out, even though that's in trouble. And this one over here too, these are the two that are having a hard time getting started. And as you see maybe on the tag, it's the organic Wellington, which is having the trouble. These others along here generally look pretty good. There are a few that look a little sun scorched or a little bit like they're struggling, but I think we're gonna be okay with all of them. We need to keep them wet. I'm about to water everything tonight. On the other row, the peppers, the eggplants down there look like the big transplants are doing well. The little ones, a couple of them are struggling. Peppers look really good. Brussels sprouts look good down here. We need to get a lot of water onto all this. It's definitely dry. I'm stepping over that. This next row over here you see is all new, and that is the melons. And they're still struggling. They're definitely feeling some shock from their transplant. We've had two very hot days. So they're still adjusting from that.
We got a pretty serious soaking rain last night. Actually, it was a major thunderstorm, but it rained and rained and rained and rained and rained as hard as many of these rains we've had that flooded the lake. Good news is the lake seems to be riding it out okay. Water's still falling. I'm sure we'll have a little bump over the next 12 hours or so as the river's empty, but the garden is what I'm checking on now, and you can see that things are looking a little beaten down, especially over here with the tomatoes. Those last two were scorched by the sun, but they're actually, they got new growth. You can see all the others are really looking bedraggled along here, but I think that they'll, with some sunshine, bounce back. It'll make them healthy again because it'll get a lot of water down to the roots. There is one here that just clearly was smashed to bits. It's literally snapped right in half. So we may end up having to replace that one, or I do see that down at the bottom there's a sucker started, and that sucker hopefully can be encouraged into, we'll actually go ahead and pull that right off, put it there next to it. Hopefully that sucker will grow into a enough of a healthy plant that we can recover from that. These, I mean, they're looking beaten up, but they're okay. They're looking sturdy enough. I see a lot of sun scorch on that one from early on, but making it, this one down here pounded down pretty well, but I think it'll be all right. We'll go ahead and tilt that up. We'll be getting the wires up on here to train these shortly. Eggplant, again, looking pretty muddy and beaten up by the storm, but all right, you see these teeny, teeny little ones. We've had a couple of these that have hung on. These are tiny eggplants and some that are going to have to be replaced. I did keep a few in store. Peppers look good. Down at the far end, Brussels sprouts look good. The new row of melons over there are definitely struggling, but I think they're struggling more from the hot, the dry the last couple of days than from the rain. So they're the things that I'm choosing to grow that would be voluntarily growing, and there would be the things that I'm not choosing to grow. With all of the rain in the last 24 hours, these fellows have decided to come up. Don't know if they're poisonous, don't know if they're edible. Maybe you know. Let me know what you think. Mostly, I've been excited that the water's finally going down in the lake, the flooding's going down, and the boathouse is coming up. Hello again. Thanks for the questions. Time for another video.
Time for another video.
Hey, it's the man in the hat. Tell me what I'm doing wrong, and tell me how to get rid of all the clay in my soil. Thanks, really appreciate it.